feel like every single story that I do where I talk about anti-vaxxers, they're all stupid. You could throw them all into that same category. But there are some anti-vax stories that are measurably dumber than others, and this is probably at the tippy top of idiotic anti-vax stories, because there is a private school in Miami, Florida, and they are putting in requirements so that way if students get vaccinated, they're the ones who have to quarantine for 30 days. Not if you're unvaccinated or you've been exposed to COVID. No, if you've been vaccinated, they are requiring that you quarantine for 30 days. It is not based on scientific fact. It is very clearly based on stupidity and delusions. Nonetheless, let's read about why they're requiring this. As Bess Levin of Vanity Fair explains, back in April, a Florida private school made headlines for demonstrating that its founders, who charge up to $30,000 a year in tuition, didn't understand basic science. Centner Academy did so by sending faculty and staff a letter informing them that if they chose to get vaccinated against COVID-19, they would have to stay away from students, falsely claiming that non-vaccinated people have been negatively impacted by interacting with people who had been vaccinated, and also that it knew of at least 3 women with menstrual cycles impacted after having spent time with a vaccinated person. Holy shit. Obviously, none of what Leela Centner, who started the school with her husband David, wrote was true, but that didn't stop her from telling employees that anyone who planned to get vaccinated would not be allowed to be near our students until more information is known, and that if they chose to get vaccinated over the summer, they wouldn't be allowed to return until clinical trials were completed, and only if a position is still available at that time. For many parents, news of such a policy would be a reason to immediately pull their kid from Centner Academy, not just for safety reasons, but also because Leela and David are clearly morons. None of the vaccines available in the US include the live virus, so it is impossible for an inoculated person to negatively impact an unvaccinated person with the vaccine's components, as people who don't know what they're talking about claim. In fact, as the Centners apparently don't understand, it's biologically impossible. But for the parents who have kept their kids enrolled in the school, the founders have a new message. If you vaccinate your kid, they'll have to stay home for 30 days following each shot. Okay, so I've got to ask the obvious question. Why are these morons allowed to have a school? I feel like the standards that are put into place, state, federal standards, they're not good enough if people like this are allowed to have a school. I mean, do they have a science class in this school? Who teaches it? I need more details, because this isn't just insane, it is almost a parody. Like, it borders on parody. This is something that you'd expect from the people in Idiocracy in the event, you know, that movie, or now documentary rather, kind of documented a plague. It's clearly bizarre. And in the email, they kind of go through their logic, and here's what they say. So this is no surprise. They say that the vaccines are experimental. No, they're not experimental. That's factually incorrect, because they are out of clinical trials. So no, they're not experimental. They claim that vaccinated people are shedding the virus to unvaccinated people. Let me repeat that. If you got vaccinated, they believe that you are shedding the virus and infecting other people who are unvaccinated with COVID-19. Now, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard, but let's assume that this batshit insane theory is correct. Okay, well, if there are so many vaccinated people now shedding the virus, wouldn't you want to get vaccinated yourself so that way it won't affect you, since the vaccines are safe and effective? I mean, it's not happening, but even in their bizarro worldview, okay, sure, you're going to shed the virus to others, according to them, but at least you'll be protected. Self-preservation. I mean, this is, folks, this is not okay. These beliefs are stupid. This is QAnon level of dumb. This is flat earther level of stupid. They've also discouraged teachers and students, no surprise, from wearing masks. I'm assuming because maybe they buy into Louis Gohmert's theory that if you wear the mask, you breathe in your own CO2 and that gives you the virus, and somehow it materializes on the mask. I mean, I can't really try to psychoanalyze them and try to explain their logic, because there is no logic to this. It's the absence of logic. And I don't know what to say. This is an actual school, and parents are paying $30,000 a year to have dipshits teach their kids. I mean, you should really get a refund if you're sending your kid to the school. You're not going to go to this school, or you're not going to send your kid to this school unless you are very, very wealthy. And there's always this this idea that charter schools are preferable because they have better standards, better, you know, opportunities for your children. The teachers have more expertise. It's better than public schools. I mean, this kind of alone disproves that, right? So I don't know what to say. This story, it almost made my head explode reading the details. And I read this earlier in preparation for the segment, but as I read it again, it's still shocking to me because this is really fucking stupid stuff, particularly the idea that vaccinated people can shed the virus. If you honestly believe that vaccinated people are shedding the virus, I genuinely don't know how you can be alive to reach adulthood. You've got to at some point just spontaneously forget how to breathe and die. You've got to crack your head open and get a concussion from tying your own shoelaces together. This is really low IQ shit. And I mean, it's shocking that they're so confident in their stupidity. I mean, this is Dunning Kruger in action, but yeah, there you have it. They're making people or children who get vaccinated quarantine for 30 days. Jesus Christ. This is the dumb fuckery that you can expect from anti-vaxxers.
Ideas. Recovery mode, my brain ideas. Recovery mode, my brain ideas.